Welcome to the Ranch Rodeo. This is the 8th annual Dakota Roughrider Saddle Club Ranch Rodeo. We welcome you on a beautiful evening on the 3rd of July, and we have got some of the very best Ranch Rodeo teams in the state right here to duel it out for some sweet prizes. We're in. Sean Anderson and Shane Anderson. Next up, we've got Bowman Red Angus. Bowman Red Angus, Jake Bowman, Ross Odie, Luke Honeyman, and Logan Schaffer. Following them will be four guys on horses. J.R. West, Doug Owey, Chance West, and Adam Warner. Next will be Kwame Feedlot, Casey Kwame, Pat Smith, Chad Hansen, and Casey Hyatt. Following them will be Envision, Dustin Jones, Hunter Shell, Lane Schmidt, and Lane Marshall. That is Envision. Then we've got J-Bar H. Ranch, made up of Jim Heisted, Jason Jensen, Austin Hetland, and Ronnie Jagger. After them, it's Corral Supply, Colby Anderson, James Kapp, Pat Flaherty, and Joe Matisse. And last but not least will be Vegan Horse Company, Brent Vegan, Bryce Vegan, Zach Hoven, and Jesse Feist. And these are your 2014 Ranch Rodeo teams. As they stand in front of you, let them hear you just one more time. And now it's my privilege to introduce into the arena Reagan, and she is the 2014 White Earth Valley Saddle Club Little Miss. Let's hear it for Reagan Hilbury. And everybody stand to your feet as you are able and remove your headgear, stand at attention as Kylie Hildry presents the American flag, and she is the 2014 White Earth Valley Saddle Club Princess. And she's just returning from the national, both Hildry girls are just returning from the National Junior High Finals in Des Moines, Iowa. And at this time, folks, I'd ask that you take a second look at that red, white, and blue that comes across the grandstand right now. And I want you to think about how blessed we are to live in this country, to live in a land of the free and home of the brave. And as we think about those brave, we think about the men and women of the armed services back in... It all started back in 1776 when our founding father said, we need to be independent. And since then, we've been very fortunate to live in a land that is protected by the men, and a huge thank you to their families. We appreciate everything they do and everything they continue to do, and for that, we are blessed. At this time, it's my privilege to introduce Jennifer Hildry for the singing of our national anthem. So we'll see where the pace gets set right off the bat. We're going to be looking for some times that are going to be... We are going to have some rules, obviously, to govern, and therefore some judges. We want to say a big thank you to Mark and Hal Kramer. They're going to be our judges for the Ranch Rodeo. North Country Mercantile has got theirs caught. They're mugging in the process. Last year's championship team wants to set a pretty good representation here, and these guys are fast as fast can be. North Country Mercantile has turned in some of the fastest times I've seen done in ranch rodeos in North Dakota. As they're trying to get that flag to drop, and there it goes. Dock and Construction not far behind them as they're getting ready to drop. There it is. Well, I tell you what, it looks like we're already going to set the pace pretty quickly. And not only are we going to beat that 45-second mark that I maybe mentioned a little bit ago, but how about North Country Mercantile at 40.99 seconds to set the pace? You bet. And Doc, we see in the steer mugging there at 48.49. That is a pretty outstanding. We want to let everybody know that you can stop over and see Frank and Rosie in the concession stand, and there are raffle tickets over there. And time is in. Anderson Trucking, if you're looking for them out there, they are in the all black. Calvin Red Angus, it looks like they've got a catch. It looks like Jake Bauman is the one on the rope, and then Logan Chopper taking it to the ground. I tell you, there's a lot of muscle in that tie-down roper right there. It's right in front of you, Anderson Trucking just opened up their work here. Steer to the ground. Now it takes a little time, this steer's easy on him. As time is in. Oh, swinging a miss for four guys on horses. Kwame Feedlot heading the other direction. They're spreading out the arena. It's hard to, looks like four guys on horses. Got a hold of it, but having trouble getting it to the ground. And we got Kwame Feedlot right in front of Grant because a team doesn't necessarily have to do well in the first round to win it. They just have to stay in the hunt. Consistency will pay off. Time goes in the books, and I will give it to you. As four guys on horses, and that steer is fighting, so they better hope that they've got it tied good. So we've got four guys on horses with a time of 1 minute 44.67 seconds, and Kwame Feedlot right behind him at 1 minute 48.01 seconds. And it's 29, and JRH, you guys have number six. We also have Lane Finneseth out there. He's taking pictures. Yeah, time is in. Envision. We've got theirs caught. JRH Ranch caught as well. Boy, those are some cool blue shirts they got on. That's blue, right? I'm colorblind, so sometimes I'm guessing. And time to stop for Envision. I think Envision's gonna like their time of 43.41, and that's good enough for second spot. And Dave R.H. runs in with a minute 6.43 seconds. A minute 6.43. Yeah, time is it. Corral Supply's got theirs caught. Corral Supplies working on wrapping them up. Could be fast, but these boys will have to get their hands in the air if they want to take the lead. Vegan Horse Company's got a little struggling going on with theirs. And Corral Supply luckily got a fighter. But it looks good. Nicely done. You bet. 50.3 seconds for Corral Supply. 2.9 is going to finish us up. A minute 53.29. I have a quick question. How many of you are from Velva? It was several years ago. And here we go. Bowen Red Angus working on catching theirs right here by the irons. Are they going for the heel? Yes, yes, looks good. Anderson Trucking still working on fishing on that head loop as they got it. Bowman Red Angus is looking to make up for last event's no time as they stop the clock. Anderson Trucking. So you see the strategy, Bowman Red Angus right in front of the bucket. They save a lot of running. Four guys on horses will have number 5 and Kwame Feedlot number 42. Swing and a miss for four guys on horses. You got a head catch? And heel catch. Gotta get him to the ground. Done deal. Gotta work on the brakes. There it slowing down a little bit this event, but qualified time coming close. And check out this strategy. One runner one way, runner the other way, fresh legs. Gets it done that much faster. You bet. Supply catching right in front of the stands. Fishing for vegans. Doesn't work. Head catch. Heel catch, baby. Yes. Heads up. Vegan Horse Company stopping the clock. Stop for Corral Supply, North Country Mercantile, and Dockin Construction, the last two teams. Next event will be the Wild Cow Milking. Time to beat of 27.36 seconds. Let's see what'll happen here. Let's get ready to rumble! Dockin Construction got a head catch as North Country Mercantile working that way. Now getting as close to the iron as they can as they get the heel catch. There it is. Dockin Construction stops the clock. Whoa. Ah, North Country Mercantile, sometimes you rush things so quickly. That almost worked. Four guys on horses. There we go. Oh, she's cooperative as all get up. There's the mount. Time stops for four guys on horses. Yes, it worked. Kwame Feedlot having to do a little bit more work as they come across the arena. That time is it. Still no catches. And as I say that, J-Bar H swings in and it looks like they're going to go for the heel. Miss it, but now the tail hold. Keep that cow from kicking. Getting into the process of milking. At least they're close to the judge. Jim's trying to find the milk and the cow they have. J-Bar H stops the clock. And so does it. Yeah. Mercantile Supply with the head catch. Vegan's got their head catch. Struggling. As Vegan Horse Company. At a minute .01. Your Mercantile popped down to third place. Country Mercantile in the red, Dock and Construction in the orange.
There was a cloud of dust down on the road on a Friday night. County Sheriff and old man John had a feeling that so they followed a beer can trail and they took it from a river bank. There was girls and guys and four-wheel drives and 500 watts of hay.
Well, the Austin Construction with a feisty one. North Country Mercantile says, hey, we want to catch up. And one way to do it is to beat Austin Construction. North Country Mercantile with a 47.94. Dock and Construction with 1 minute 12.59 seconds as we finish up with. After this event, we'll go. Last two teams of the Wild Cow Milking. Bowman Red Angus. Got their shot. They're trying to beat that fast time and get themselves a first place ticket. Anderson Trucking has got their cow subdued right in front of you all. Bowman Red Angus stops the clock. Anderson Trucking with the young. Trying to set the pace here. The first two teams to go on the trailer loading. It looks like that we've got to just catch first. Vision with a catch. Into the trailer, there it goes. You know, this part of the ranch rodeo is, once they get them caught and headed in the right direction, these cattle love what they do so much that when Jim goes to load them up to go to a next event, he just parks the trailer out in the pasture and they load themselves up. That's how much they enjoy what they do. Well, maybe that's a little bit of exaggeration. Yeah, here we go. It's time to beat a 59.49 seconds. I don't know if that's gonna work. He throws the drill. There's Vegan Horse Company with their catch. Trailer is open. And they could take the lead with this run if everything goes well right up until here. We need the guy to shut the gate. Time has stopped for vegans. Horse Company will come in with a 56.23. This might be the final time that these two teams are paired for this ranch rodeo. Let's see right here if they can push each other to break that speed bubble that currently sits at 56.23 seconds. Tough break for Docky Construction as the rope kind of just pops off. What was looking to be a fast run. North Country Mercantile right in front of you. You got it? Looks like they're turning towards the trailer. Look out. Leaderboard. And of course, they get the one that does not load. Docky Construction. Oh my goodness. Didn't get the slack out of the rope as North Country Mercantile stops the clock and will go to the lead at 42.67 seconds. Pressure is on. Dock and Construction needs to salvage what they can out of this run and get this steer into the trailer as quickly as possible if they want to stay in the hunt up to the last event. Things are going to be shaken up a little bit. 0.83 seconds. 1 minute, 7.83. North Country Mercantile redeeming themselves with a 42.67. And that's... Ah, here we go. There's Logan Stopper. Going along, but they need a little cooperation. And look at that, all of a sudden Andersons are right there and looking to stop the clock ahead of them. This is going to be neck and neck. These two teams need fast times. Anderson, I tell you what, you guys should feel pretty good. That was a run that you guys definitely needed. Far behind them, it looks good enough for third place, Bauman Red Angus Ranch. Once again, and they've got it. Four guys on horses are right in front of their trailer and they mean business. They know they've got an opportunity, but they got to get the steer loaded and get it. This is going to be really fast. If they can get it in, shut the gate, get out of the way, call it good. Time has stopped. I think by a long ways they're going to take the lead in this event, and that is something that definitely needed to happen. No slow approach by Kwame Feedlot either, as they stop it at 37.82, but check out the time, four guys on horses, 28.27 under 30 second run, sits them in first place for the event. That baton does not hit the ground. Right now there's a little bit of struggle between the exchange right there and the horse is not working. Whoa! is going to switch mounts. Time is stopped for corral supply. 1 minute 27.69 seconds. Keep track of that time and we'll watch as we move through the order how it changes. All the way back up to the... Looks like we're ready to go. Time is in. Unload and mount the first step and go. Pagan Horse Company comes out to an early lead. Vegans are coming in for their last exchange. Oh, and it looks like Envision has definitely caught up and taken the lead. Without getting on the truck. And times have stopped. Construction and JRH Ranch, and these teams have to, and I mean have to, set the fastest times if they want a chance at this ranch rodeo. I think they're already off to a pretty good start. Docking Construction has made their first exchange. JRH Ranch a little bit behind, they're gonna have to make some ground. Possibly in their exchanges. The docking construction, almost a full lap ahead, three quarters of a lap ahead. This is going to be vital for them. Last one for docking construction. Halfway left to go. JRH Ranch coming around the horn. Time to stop for docking construction. One second is the time to beat. And we're off. First one around for Bob and Red Angus. fast. If you're having trouble, you gotta take off fast. You gotta cruise, nothing to lose. Rock Loose, Anderson Trucking. Ooh. You're not only racing against the other team, you're racing against a minute 17.01. Sitting in third and fourth, you guys are going to want to get the fastest time on the board as that exchange goes a little crazy. Jake Bauman still trying to grab it. And that's where trying to hurry and not just going through the motions can get you in trouble. Jake Bauman's coming around the horn. He's going to finish it off for Bauman. Red Angus Anderson Trucking doing the same. These guys are neck and neck right now. Okay, I don't know what exactly how this shakes out, so I'm going to let the timers write stuff down. But if you remember that time I told you to remember of a minute 17.01, you can continue to remember that time. I can tell you that much. Of a minute 25.72 and Anderson Trucking a minute 25.02. Now, North Country Mercantile go to the silver. And here we go. Watch every single movement from the first rider getting on his horse to every exchange. Yeah, look at this, neck and neck right off the bat. But I tell you what, North Country Mercantile got a little bit more horsepower coming out of this first round as we see them a little bit ahead of the pace as they go to the first exchange. But this could be the key right here. Make sure you get the baton toss, North Country Mercantile. Definitely in the lead right now as we see things out. But look, a little bit of hitch from North Country Mercantile gives school guys on horses a little bit of an opportunity, but they can't capitalize on it. Here goes the third exchange for both teams. North Country Mercantile definitely gaining some ground here. It's going to have to take some battles on North Country Mercantile's part to see if they're going to give it back to four guys on horses. Four guys on horses just not able to kind of put this together, the kind of run. North Country Mercantile is pulling ahead significantly. North Country Mercantile out of first place at this point. Adam Water for four guys on horses. He's just going to have to bring it around the horn to finish it up. But trying to stop for North Country Mercantile. Now, of course, for four guys on horses, a little trouble. And the time stops. Okay. This is how I've got to explain this to you, okay? First of all, four guys on horses, I want to give you their time. It's a minute 26.3. I don't remember it anymore because North Country Mercantile put a minute 14.73, which I'm not a mathematician, but according to my calculations, that would make them the winners unofficially. We'll wait till we officially get everything tallied. But a valiant effort definitely came out, did what they needed to do in order to win this ranch rodeo. What a great competition all around. Hats off to all of the teams. Give them a round of applause. They have just worked their butts out in the arena tonight. And what a great show. Thank you everybody that came out. We'll get results to you as soon as we get them tallied up. But appreciate everybody. Make sure you get home safe. Take care. God bless and have a happy 4th of July. Saddle Club, and in fourth place JRH Ranch, in third place Anderson Trucking, in second place Four Guys on Horses, and in first place North Country Mercantile, winners for the second year in a row. Congratulations to all.